Welcome to my YouTube channel, Sociocratic. I am Prashant Kumar. We are discussing about the tenth standard social science topics. Today, let us going to discuss about development. What is development? Commonly, development means immediately in our mind it comes money. Those who are rich, those who are becoming rich, they are developed. Those who are poor, not developed. See construction here. So money, currency. So that comes. Actually, it is not the development. So what is the development? Let us discuss about that today. Let us start development lesson. Yeah. Now, what is development? The process, the progress of a particular field or a particular person. Any particular field, we get the progress, there is development. Or any person who got the progress in his life, there is a development. Or can be defined another way, process of enhancing society's capacity to satisfy its needs on a large scale. The society's capacity to satisfy the needs of the people is not in a small scale, in a large scale. That is the development. And development means immediately we will get different words. And there is rural development, social development, educational development, women and children development. So like that, many developments we listen every day. Yeah. And whenever economic activities of a country expand, it is called economic development. Yeah. So what is economic development then? So here, Professor Mayer and Baldwin, they gave one definition about the economic development. Economic development is a process whereby an economy's real national income increases over a long period of time. Here, I highlighted some words, italicized and also in the bold letter it is written. Economic development is a process whereby an economy's real national income increases over a long period of time. So what are these three words? Process, real national income, and long period. Let us see that. First one, process. Economic development is a process. What is a process? Operation of the forces that bring about changes in supply of factors of production and in the structure of demand for the production. So here, operation of the forces that bring about the changes. The supply of factors of production. Factors of production, which are the factors of production? You learned in the lower class about this. Land, labor, capital, organization are the factors of production. For land, we will get rent. Labor, we will get wages. And capital, we will get interest. And organization, profit, like that. Okay. So, in the change in the supply of the factors of production, and in the structure of demand in the production. Demand always play a very important role in the economy. And changes in the factor supply take place due to the discovery of additional resources, education, skill development, capital accumulation, population growth, or adoption of better techniques. In the production, we adopt better techniques. So like that, some changes in the demand. This is one process. It is not a small thing, it is a process. So that is the one thing. Economic development is a process. It is a real national income. What is national income then? National income is the total value of all goods and services produced in a country during 1 year. In a year. The value of total goods and services produced in a country, that is the national income. And what is the real national income? Here, total value of the goods and services produced in the country, okay, someone they produce more, someone they will not produce, so we can't judge that one. But real national income says about the purchasing power of the income. Our income increases, but purchasing power increasing. When the purchasing power increases? When the income increases, price also increasing. Where is the purchasing power increasing? Purchasing power same. So that's why real national income counts here. Okay, that is the development. In the development developmental process, when the purchasing power increases, then it's okay. That we call it as economic development. Long period. This economic development is not a short period process. It is a long period. The increase in real national income should be sustained over a long period of or about 10 years or more than 10 years. Purchasing power, increasing the purchasing power, not one person here, everyone's. So purchasing power increasing means it is a not a small one, it is a big process. That's why. And this short term one's income are not considered. This month 1 lakh income, next month it is a 2 lakh, not like that. Yeah, it's a long period. In long period of fluctuation, when it happens that the development takes place, so that is economic development. And sometimes in the real national income, in national income, what happens? What we think, the country which is having higher national income is developed, lower national income underdeveloped. So only national income is not possible. Let us discuss later about that. Now, so here, Colin Clark defines the economic development as an improvement in the economic welfare. So what is economic welfare? Improving economic welfare of the people means it is the reducing the economic ills or economic problems like poverty. Poverty is the biggest problem for economy. If you reduce that, it is improvement in economic welfare. Yeah. So this is to improve the economic welfare. How it is possible? We have to include all the sections of the society. So that's why inclusive development and sustained development came. These two words came. What is inclusive development? Ensuring that every person is benefited by the process of development. There are not one or two. Every person in the society is included there. They are benefited by the process of development. Then it is inclusive development. Nowadays, in the fire plans, they are doing that one. Inclusive growth. That is the aim of the fire plan. So like that. So every person should be benefited. What is sustained development? So whatever the people, so if we get the benefit, it's okay. Next generation will spoil the nature, will spoil the environment, will get the benefit. Development takes place, but next generation, can they live? So sustained development, very important one. Preserving natural resources and the environment for the benefit of future generations is also very important one. So preserving natural resources, forest, water, environment, all these things for the benefit of the future generation. What we got from our ancestors, we have to protect it. We have to enrich it. We have to hand over that one with good condition to the next generation. That is sustained development. Only spoiling is not development. So, this one included nowadays. And developed countries means what? Before 1950s, USA, Canada, Japan, Germany, England, Australia, etc. called as developed countries. After 1950s, Singapore, Hong Kong, Malaysia, China, etc. became developed countries. Okay, development, okay. Now, underdevelopment means what? Underdevelopment. Here, a backward and stagnant situation where low level of living due to the low per capita income and low productivity is called underdevelopment. Productivity level is low, per capita income is low, and level of living also low. Everything is below the line. It is a backward, it is underdeveloped. Yes. And here, commonly what United Nations comparing the countries, their underdeveloped countries means their per capita income, real per capita income, what we say, that should be lower than the USA, Canada, Australia, and some other Western European countries. They are called as underdeveloped countries. They compare that. With the comparison with these developed countries, they say others are underdeveloped. And another thing we have to think here, all the countries are not underdeveloped. With that, one new thing came, a new word came, that is a developing country. What is a developing country? The underdeveloped nations are capable of development and are making serious efforts to overcome their problems of low income and poverty. They are developing countries. Okay, and here World Development Report of World Bank that says that it divided the countries into three groups: high income, medium income and low income. And it categorized high income groups under developed countries and medium income and low income under developing countries. So like this it divided World Development Report of World Bank. Yeah. Now, how to measure development? Is it possible? What is the measuring rod? So let's discuss about that. Indicators of development. How to? Only comparison, is it okay? I told UNO is comparing with America, Canada, etc. No, that is not good. So one measuring rod necessary. Which is the measuring rod? Let us see that. Can you take national income as the measuring rod? Higher national income developed and lower national income underdeveloped. Can we do that? No. It is not appropriate to measure the development because it will not consider better health facility. National income is good, but health facility not good. Yes, and better sanitation facility, not there. Better education facility, not there. Only national income, we can't take that one. National income is more, but facility not there. So then we can't consider only national income. And national income is more, the people, their per capita income is less. Can we take then per capita income? Let us see that per capita income. The higher per capita income is a developed country and the lower per capita income underdeveloped country. Can we do that? No, it is also not possible. It is also not appropriate to measure development because it does not consider distribution of income, availability of basic amenities like food, shelter, education, health, etc. For example, country A, its per capita income is $5,000. And country B, its per capita income is $8,000. And what we think here, country B is developed, 5,000 less, 8,000 more, so that one developed. But here one thing we have to remember, in the country A, 80% of the people, they are leading happy life and above the poverty line, no problem at all. 20% they are suffering a little bit. And but in B, country B, they 80% people, they are suffering, they are below the poverty line, and 20% highly rich. They are having multi-story building, many industries, etc. They are very rich people. Because of the dividing the total national income by the population, there it is 8,000 comes, here 5,000 comes. So can we say, only 20% people developed there, can we say that country is developed? Not possible. That's why per capita income also not the proper way to measure the development. Then how it is possible? So that one we have to think. Attempts are made to extend the income measure by including other parameters. So these, they are called as alternative indicators. So that one we have to see, human development indicators. And what is that human development indicator? That one we have to see now. And here, human development, especially enhancement of human welfare, and basic amenities like food, shelter, clothing, education, health, sanitation, social security, clean water. So all these things they have to get. And their increase in the income may not guarantee of all these above whatever I told now. and they have to get all these facilities also. That's why, according to Mahbubul Haq from Pakistan, he was influenced by the writings of the Nobel awardee Amartya Sen, great economist. Important requirements to enjoy the decent standard of living are, according to Mahbubul Haq, important requirements to enjoy the decent standard of living, your ability to lead a healthy and long life, being literate, having income to purchase the minimum amenities. These three very important one. If these three also there, then that person is called, he called that country or that person is a human development. He called this as human development. If these three are there in the country, then it is a development. He told like that. So now let us see how to do by the base of this one. We have to think about that. Human Development Index, HDI. What is HDI, etc.? We have to think. HDI, Human Development Index, is a criteria formed by the United Nations Development Program, UNDP, to measure the quality of human life. Indicators of Human Development. So here, Human Development Indicators, the criteria, what it says, 3 points they mentioned. Life expectancy, educational achievement, standard of living. By life expectancy, we can measure the health of the people. Educational achievement, by this literacy rate we can get. Standard of living, by the purchasing power of the people we can get. So what is life expectancy? The age till which the people of a country can expect to live or expect to survive. That is the life expectancy. And educational achievement. Average period of schooling completed by the individual above 25 years. The people, those who cross the 25 years, cross the age of 25, average period of schooling, someone degree they did, someone didn't go to the school, someone only one first standard, someone 10th standard, like that, average we have to take. Then, expected period of school education might receive in lifetime by the children of 5 years. Now, those who are up to 5, they have to get education in future. Their number, by that we can get education achievement. And standard of living, purchasing power, means per capita income we have to think. Real per capita income we have to think. So when we take the average of these three, that is Human Development Index. To measure the human development, we have to take the average of these three. That is important one. And here in India, the Human Development Index in 2012, it was 0.554. India stands 136th rank out of 186 countries. And in 2014, it was 0.586. 135th rank out of 187. Okay, so this is the Human Development Index. Next, we have to think another section here, gender-related development. Common problem, while discussing about the problems of women, problems of India in that status of women, there we discussed. The women, they are suffering a lot. They were not given equal opportunity, their feelings were not given importance, etc. We discussed. And it is the duty of civilized society to provide social, economic, education and political equality to women. And are we giving now? Everywhere. That one we have to think. So, by observing this, the sex ratio. What is sex ratio? Number of female for every 1,000 males. In India, it is a 945 in 2011 census. For 1,000 male, only 945 female are there. Number is very less. For that, many reasons are there. And here literacy rate, if you observe, female literacy rate, women literacy rate is 65.46 in 2011. But men, it is 82.14. They were not sending to school. And many women, they are working under unorganized activities like agriculture, construction work, and small scale industries. And they are getting low wages compared to the men. And in the house, why should we go outside? In the home, just observe. The women eat last after providing the food for the head of the family, children, and others. And at that time, she may get good food or not. And many times what happens, she will not get food, and it results in malnutrition. By that what happens, maternal death rate at the time of delivery or after the delivery, the mother will die, and infant deaths will be more because of malnutrition. So this is the problem. And for this one, another problem is female feticide, killing the fetus inside the womb when it is found in the scanning, ultrasound scanning. If they find it is a female baby, they will abort, they will kill that. So because of all these, it is the problem. Can we solve it? Measure to achieve gender equality. Promote gender equality at home first. From our home, we have to start it. Start this one. Curb social practices like dowry, polygamy, sati, etc. Promote girls' education. Stopping the practice of male hair. All are equal, we have to think. So that is important one. And here another thing we have to remember, to improve the condition of women, mainly to promote the participation of women in the economic activities and thereby to achieve economic empowerment of women, women self-help groups came into effect, that emerged. Women self-help groups, commonly in the self-help group 20 members are there. They will help each other. They will get many benefits from that. So very important one, this point in the examination point, and students have to remember this for the examination point of view. It is a very important one, these points. How women help, self-help group helpful for the women. Helps to undertake business. Women, they can undertake business, and it helps to earn income. Helps to share their meager resources. Helps to obtain external support. They will get external support there. And meager, so this one, earn income, this is very, these two very easy. And helps to share their meager resources. So whatever the resource they have, if they come together, it becomes a big capital. And they can start the big one. For example, Sri Gramodaya Yojana from Dharmasthala. So it is a big one now. As few people, they started that one. See now how big it is. So it is possible to develop. How many people, they got employment opportunity there. We will become self-sufficient. It is possible. Everyone should come forward. We should not think about the white collar job. Helps to obtain external support here, because when it is registered, even self-help group, it is registered, they will get subsidy, a loan, etc. Helps to undertake business jointly and earn income. So all the members of that self-help group, they can start the business jointly. They can start pickle business, or they can start many other homemade items. They can sell that. Together they can work and earn income, their own income. They will become independent because of that. They don't have to beg with others. And trained in managing accounts and handling bank transactions. So they have to remit money every month or every week, like that they will take. And that becomes a big amount. And they can invest, it become a capital. And they can get the loan also there. And to manage that, manage the account and handling the bank transaction is possible for them. And they can get the skills to take up remunerative income, income generating activities. So one by one activity they starts. When they come together, one idea comes in their mind, and income generating activities they will start, and they will get the good skill in that one. And they can improve their business. And helps women to earn, save, and spend at their willing. And their willingness, they can spend money and they can use it and they will become independent. They don't have to depend on others. When they start to depend on others, others will curb them. That's why. So women helps help group, very important one. So let them develop. So they have to develop together. The country will develop. So this is the main topic about the development. Thank you.